They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They start on the ground with Elliott. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second.
Whenever I go to a team's practice facility and watch them work, I love to watch the defensive guys in what they call pursuit drills. The ball goes either towards them or away from them. How fast will they respond? On this play, the defensive end responded better than anyone and made a really nice play.
And this one caught by Dez Bryant. That'll be a gain of 15 yards. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. An early test for this defense. Here we go on third and inches.
Let's go! 190! 190!
Now it's the Florida Atlantic alone. This is Alfred Morris. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
Come on, that's it.
They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott. Room here to run. The 30. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott, 60 yards, and the Cowboys have taken the early lead. You talk about explosion plays, there's one pretty much right out of the gate.
And now they get to ride a wave of emotion, momentum, everything. Just as you described, right out of the gate, big sprint, touchdown, they're excited. But on the other side, they've got to guard against a major letdown because they hit them right in the gut with that one. And now you start to question yourself a little bit when you give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. They come up with one back. That's Ingram. Throwing now is Breeze. It's caught left side by Cooks. It'll be a gain of six, and that'll bring up second down.
And that's the kind of pass that adds up over time, Brandon. You may not have picked up a first down there, but if you keep chipping away at it, eventually big plays may result.
They'll run for the first time with Mark Ingram. A three-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard. And the quarterback, he's got some big threats at wideout.
And they seem to get bigger all the time, don't they, Brandon? Every time I look out and watch a game, we're getting these bigger, more athletic, acrobatic receivers. We have some today.
And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run. Breeze to throw on third and one. This is caught. It's Cooks. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. So the offense has it first and 10. They toss to Ingram. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards. And now it's second down.
There's so many things that go into playing the position of linebacker. Some of them are actually subtle. Doing the drill work that you do all the time in practice and carrying it over to the game. Get rid of blockers and get to the ball carrier. Knock him down for a loss.
Now Breeze. Caught right side. It's Snead. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down. And here's a look at the defensive unit that hopes to halt this offense today. Defense has set themselves up nicely. Third and 10 now. Now Breeze on third down. Left side and caught by Flaner. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
appears Sean Payton's made the decision here. They will go for it on fourth. Breeze to throw for it on four. And Thomas has it. It'll be a gain of four. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up, because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. This is Ingram on first and 10. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Can we just take that run and turn it into a kind of a clip and save? Because that tells you everything you need to know about this drive. They've been moving the ball awfully well.
On second down, here's Breeze. He throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. It's a 9-yard gain and it keeps the drive moving. Fresh set of downs here. Breeze gives it up to Ingram. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. It'll be a gain of three, and it also takes us to the end of the first quarter of play. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Saints football to begin quarter number two. They face a second and 7 to start things out. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. Breeze to throw on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Now they got to get to the 23 here on third. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
But just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. Breeze looking to throw on third and two. It's complete to Flaner. They get 9 yards there, and they get a first down. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
To the running game. It's Ingram. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage. Back at the 17. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Man, wasn't that long ago that the guy playing that spot was an outside linebacker type of a guy. Now, as a defensive end, how about the speed that he used to get into the backfield and make the play?
Here we go. Ready. Five.
Now Breeze throwing on second down. That is caught at the 7-yard line. He'll wind up getting 11 on that one. And they'll be faced with a third and inches.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
They'll try to run for the first with Ingram. They give them 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal.
Now, that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handle it a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
And this seemingly endless drive continues.
Ready. Easy. Here we go.
First down and goal. The offense knocking on the door. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
So often you hear defensive coaches talk about we need all 11 on every play in order to be a good...
And he'll score! Touchdown, New Orleans! Willie Snead taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. And the D looking like they may blitz.
Here we go!
Again, it's Elliott. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on 3rd down? Third and short yardage, Prescott. Finding Alfred Morris, complete. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
There are a lot of tough routes to try and cover. When you see a runner come out of the backfield and run this angle route, looks like they're going to the flat, and then they put their foot in the ground and cut back sharply inside. Not easily covered, and then when they catch it, good momentum built up by them as well.
And able to pick up the first. And this one's incomplete. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's 2nd down. They come out here in the eye. On 2nd down, Elliott. Able to push forward for about 4 down to the 37. Craig Robertson in on the stop. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. First down marker at the 31. It's 3rd down. On 3rd down, it's Prescott. He completes it to Bryant. And he's able to pick up the 1st down here before he goes down at the 26. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. Elliott, toss right. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here.
Flex round! Here we go! Grand 38!
Ohio! Ohio!
Here we go!
White 90!
Flex round! Flex
round!
Let's go!
Flex round!
White 90!
White
90! Flex round!
Here we go!
White 90!
They go to Elliott again, and he is going to lose yardage here. He lost 4 there, and it's 3rd down. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the 1st on 3rd. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete. The Cowboys will turn it over now to Dan Bailey for the field goal try. From the right hash, it's a 41-yard attempt. And Bailey knock it through. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So a little fortunate there because that one was definitely leaking right.
Without a doubt. Maybe about the width of a football or so inside that right upright. But he got it to go.
Gets fielded in the end zone. And he'll very wisely take a knee here as they'll bring this one out to the 25 on the touchback. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big...
Looking for his tight end, Fleener, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
A first down carry by Elliott. And he's going to be brought down at about the 33-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
Flex round! Flex round!
They come out here in the eye. They'll run with Elliott. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Let's go! One, nine.
Bryant, the lone receiver, left. Now Prescott. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. It'll be a loss of 10. And it'll bring up second. And now they're in the hurry up.
Oh, my goodness. Was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Well, look at the former defensive back. You're all smiles up here. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. He hit his first. Now this from 43. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that will do it for this first half. We have hit halftime. Still 2 more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Now, the offense moving in the wrong direction here now as they face a second and 12. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. To throw, it's Breeze. Brought in left side by Snead. A big play there on the catch and run, and it's going to yield a new set of downs.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
Breeze going to throw. And this will be incomplete. Kobe Fleener, the tight end, his intended target. And now it's second down. Second down following the incompletion. Breeze will try again on second down. He's got his man. It's Brandon Coleman. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And the offense lining up first and 10. They come out here in the eye. Breeze hands to Ingram. A gain of 3, second down. See if they stay on the ground for second down. They'll come out in the pistol. Breeze to throw on second down. Caught right side, it's Snead. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good pickup there of 20 yards. In the red zone this time. Man who sat out 3 seasons. This is Tim Hightower. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Second down to the offense needing 5 yards. Back to the ground, this time with Ingram. And eventually stopped just shy of the goal line, right around the 2. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
The more football I watch, the more I want to check and see if teams are going to panic when they're down on the scoreboard. And this team has shown no signs of doing that. A lot of the time, they come out after the half. Things haven't worked so well.
A short game was all he needed. He gets across the chalk for 6. Nice execution there. Good job by the O-line getting him in for the second time.
And you always have to start with credit there when you're having a big game. I mean, you don't get there by yourself. That's rare. But how about the ability to see the proper holes, pick the proper place to go, and find his way into the end zone?
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create
touchdown, Cowboys! Ezekiel Elliott, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cowboys have retaken the lead. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
And break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly, right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
And they will line up now for the 2-point try.
Black Brown! Here we go! 1-9!
They'll look to throw. This is caught. Was he in? Yes. 2 points. And, of course, on the 2-point try, had the option to run or pass. They pass it there, and it works.
Felt pretty straightforward, didn't it? An open receiver. Ball's put on him. 2 points for them.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Field comes New Orleans, and they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Here's Brush coming in. he's taken down. Randy Gregory in there to bring him down for a loss of 7.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, 3rd and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
Sneed's got it. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th.
That's certainly playing down a distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
So Breeze is going to stay out there, and they're going to go for this on 4th down. They come up in an empty set. 4 wide receivers, 1 tight end. So here we go on 4th down with Breeze. This is caught. It's Cooks. And he will have 1st down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Both sides were holding their breath there on that 4th down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the 1st down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front. But somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
Throwing now is Breeze. Setting up the receiver screen here to Thomas. It's a loss of 1 yard there, and now 2nd down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Again, they'll throw with Breeze. Brought in left side by Sneed. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Breeze going to try and throw on 3rd down. Trying to get it to Willie Sneed there, and that brings up 4th down.
Really good, smart play by the defense, understanding 3rd and short, guarding the 1st down sticks, and being able to make a play on the football and bat it down.
And a little bit surprising, the offense is going to try to go for it here. They do go for it. It's Breeze. And it is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball.
Looking for his tight end, Witten, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Sterling Moore. And it's a big turnover there on the final play of the quarter. Back now in Arlington, it's the Saints who hold the football, but they're trailing as we begin the 4th quarter of play. Now on 1st down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. On the carry, it's Hightower. And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll wind up losing 3. And now it's 3rd down. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. I mean, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
On 3rd and long, it's Breeze. It's complete to Sneed. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down. Now Breeze, gotta have this one. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And Dallas
Yes, they'll take over in terrific field position. And out now come the Cowboys. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception,
let's go.
A lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Well, they certainly got dented with that first down run. So now they've got to be back on their heels a little bit as a defense.
Second and five. Shift together here from the D-line. They come out here in the eye.
Ohio! Ohio! Here we go!
Second down, Prescott. And fights him off. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. So it's third and long, and defensively not a real surprise. They're in the dime.
Ohio! Ohio! Here we go!
Third and long for Prescott. Deep drop. And he's got his man. It's Escobar. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go through a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Second and goal from the five. They'll try again with Elliott. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Give him right around four on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. Now they've gotten it to the one. Can they get that final yard here on third and goal? It's a keeper, and he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Dak Prescott taking it in, and the Cowboys will add on to their lead.
Partner, that was simply an example of getting low, wasn't it?
It was indeed, and for the quarterback, so they get low, the line, they did their job. Is the quarterback's job just to find a crease and dive?
Find a crease and just get in there. Ordinarily, you start low yourself, get low behind that offensive line. But sometimes they do such a great job, you can almost fall forward and find the crease for a touchdown.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And last time, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. See if they can pick themselves up off the mat and do better this go around.
Sometimes I have this vision of coaches writing notes to themselves before a game. And sometimes that note says, be aggressive, stay aggressive. Maybe that's what we saw in the last possession.
Yeah, they were very aggressive. This time, will it result in points? We'll find out. Throwing on first down is Breeze. Escaping the pressure right. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there. Second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass.
So much of this game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. So here we go, first and 10 now. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. On first and 10, here's Brady. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. A great read, and it's picked off. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. Now the Cowboys' offense heads back onto the field. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. Do you think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
Toss left to Elliott. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He gets them a little over half of what they needed. Now they're looking at a third and five. So following the run, we'll see what they do here on third down. Bryant, the lone receiver left. Prescott now, finding time. Escobar with it, over the middle. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Here, Prescott, and that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Dez Bryant from 19 yards away, and the Cowboys will extend their lead.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. He's got it, and the lead stretches to 35-14. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Breeze will try again on second down. He gets it to Thomas. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 15 yards through the air on a first down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On first down, Breeze. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Back to the air on second down. It's Breeze. Caught by Snead over the middle. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Breeze now on first down. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
Well, pop, pop right there. Takes one in the pocket. And on the other end, what looks like is going to be a completed pass, it's incomplete because of the hit downfield.
Yeah, really nice job defensively. You're right, getting to the quarterback, then immediately getting to the wide receiver, causing the incompletion.
That's an aggressive, fast defense that's on its toes right now.
Brought in left side by Snead. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
Three,
And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.
Exactly right. When you start a season, everyone's goal, win all of your home games, split your road games, and you're likely going to be in the playoffs. But when you win at home, boy, what a great feeling that is. You don't even mind if people are at your house when you get home after a win like that.
So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Cowboys as we sign off and say so long from Arlington.
station, I'm from the clique. Give me space, we might ride. Most say that, baby, they don't love the clique. I thought they love you when you make it. This some mud. Yeah, this some mud.